ninth class principles of inheritance and variation. In last session, I discussed about gene inheritance and also chromosomal theory of inheritance. Okay, that was proposed by Boveri and Sutton. He proposed the how the chromosome it resembles with genes and what are the similarities present between genes and chromosome. Then T.H. Morgan, they also proposed the how the variations developed from sexual reproduction, and he selected for genetical experimental organism Drosophila melanogaster. Okay, today's class I discuss about linkage and recombination. First, what do you mean by linkage? Link is nothing but a connection or relationship. It's nothing but the linkage. But in our genetics, linkage means linkage is a physical association of two or more genes on a chromosome. Two or more genes, they are physically associated within the same chromosome. They call as a linkage. Okay, chromosome how consists 100 to thousands of genes on the same chromosome. These genes present on the same chromosome, they have shown some physical association. That association is called as a linkage. Okay. That means, look at the picture. The first in chromosome happens in two genes, gene 1 and gene 2. The two genes are present on the same chromosome, and the genes are called as a link because they are present very close to each other on the same chromosome. Hence, they are tightly linked genes. Next, the same chromosome, the genes are present on a far away. Maintain some distance from the chromosome. Such genes are also called as linked genes, but they have loosely linked. Two genes are present on the same chromosome, but based on their distance, the genes are called tightly linked and loosely linked. And the genes are present on a different chromosome, they are called as not linked, because the genes are present on a different chromosome. Okay, the linkage means physical association of two or more genes on a chromosome is called linkage. So one more question. Next, recombination are also called crossing over. Okay, recombination means that recombination process occur during the time of meiosis. In first PUC cell division chapter, I realized that in meiosis prophase first, especially during packing stage, the non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome, they are exchanged chromatids. It's called as recombination or crossing over. It means during the time of meiosis, these two are the homologous pair of chromosome. Homologous means structurally similar chromosome. These two homologous chromosome during meiosis, they have exchanged chromatids. Okay, these two chromosome, they have exchanged chromatids, is called as recombination. And the point of exchange, the region is called as chiasmata. Called as chiasmata, nothing but a recombination, exchange of chromatids between non-sister chromatid of homologous chromosome is called as recombination. Okay, these linkage and recombination both are different words, they have different definition, but both are interlinked. Okay, next I'll discuss about how the recombination is interlinked with a linkage. Okay, look at the chromosome. If these two are the homologous pair of chromosome, in homologous pair of chromosome, the alleles present on the same locus or same position. Okay, in first chromosome, A, B, C dominant alleles. In second chromosome, A, B, C recessive alleles. These two allele pairs are present in the same position.
somewhere with the one recessive allele. That means the hair shows variation or recombination. As it is in small a, small b, these two are the recessive gene combined with a capital C dominant gene. Due to crossing over, the hair shows variation. Okay, out of four chromatin, two will be recombinant types, two will be non-recombinant. During the time of gamete formation, 50% gametes will be recombinant, remaining 50% gametes will be non-recombinant chances will occur. This is the linkage and recombinant relationship. Okay, in recombination, some linked genes are assorted independently in the gametes. Okay, in that the ABC three dominant genes are intermingled, they are shows linkage, but due to recombination, these genes are exchanged their chromosome, exchanged their chromatids. Okay, these are the relationship between linkage and recombination. Okay, and recombination have shows greater variability. They have shows variation because of that reason, because of the recombination in sexual reproduction, the hair shows more variation. Next, how to find out the genes are linked or not linked? How to find out? Okay, that linkage can be find out through optanic progeny. In optanic progeny, how many of their resemblance the parent, how many of them are resemblance, they have shown variation. Based on that variation, they have find out the gene linkage, how the genes are linked. Look at the first picture. These are the linked genes. Okay, in a chromosome have conceived two genes in homologous pair A and B. These two genes are very close to each other, tightly linked. Hence, during the time of crossing over, the genes, they do not show any independent assortment because they are maintained the same allelic pair after crossing over, because the two genes are interlinked closely to each other. During the time of crossing over, the two chromatin will exchange, but after exchange, genes are present on the same chromosome. Okay, these are the possible allele combination after crossing over. They are exactly similar to the parents. Exactly similar to the parents because the two genes are more linked, hence they do not show variation. After crossing over, they are also present in the same chromatids because the two genes are close to each other. Hence, the linked genes do not show independent assortment. Look at the second picture. In the picture, the genes are less linked. That means they have shown some distance between the two genes. In the picture, they have shown the two genes are very close to each other. But in the picture, the two genes have shown some distance. They have shown less linkage. Hence, during the time of crossing over, they have shows recombinant type. Look at their allele combination. First two are the exactly similar to their parents, but remaining two, capital B combined with a capital A, A combined with B, they have exactly different to their parent. Hence, 50% of the parental type, 50% of the recombinantal type. The diagram shows that when the two genes are very close to each other, there is no variation. There is no recombinantal type. But when the two genes have shown less linkage, they have shown recombinantal type or new allelic combination. Okay, hence the loosely linked genes have shown high recombination. This is the relationship between linkage and recombination. Okay, first you understand the two genes are very close to each other. There is no new allele combination. When the two genes are loosely linked, they have shows recombination. The next one, the genes are present on a different chromosome. There is no linkage because they are not linked genes, because the genes present on a different chromosome. Hence, the
there is no linkage.
Okay,
third one, not linked genes, because the gene present on a different chromosome.
Next, these linkage and recombination can be experimentally proposed by T.H. Morgan. T.H. Morgan had experimentally proposed the linkage. Okay, he selected Drosophila for genetically study. In Drosophila, especially, he selected X chromosome. Okay, so now the sex linked chromosome in Drosophila, XX, denoted by female. XY denoted by male. He selected X chromosome of genes for study the linkage. Okay, the first cross one, he selected two parental Drosophila. One, the female will be yellow body and white eye female, and brown body and red eye male. Male is the dominant wild type. Okay, and this is the recessive yellow body and white eye. This means mutant type. Mutant type will be female, wild type will be male. And he selected only X chromosome. Hence, the female happens in two X chromosome, male happens in only one X chromosome and one Y chromosome. These are the parents selected for cross one. Female will be mutant, male will be wild, and he selected two genes. One is yellow body, white eye, and the two genes are almost very close to each other on the chromosome. Okay, these two genes are very close to each other. That means they are more linkage, tightly linked genes. Next, these two are the parents. What is the F? Gap is developed from these parents. In female, they are both have X chromosome and they have produced only one type of gametes. In male, they have the X and Y gene, hence one with the X and another Y gene. These are the gametes developed from the parents. Next, what is the possible F1 progeny? Gamete division. First, the female gamete, female X gamete fusion with the male X gamete to follow wild type progeny. Is the female, both are X chromosome, but they are represent wild type because wild is the dominant. Wild is the dominant. Next, the X chromosome combined with the Y chromosome to form a male progeny. Male progeny have shows mutant type. Okay, yellow body. Okay, this is the mutant type, this is the wild type female, mutant type male. The F1 progeny developed from F1 generation. Next, after F1 generations, go for F2 generations and crossing the two F1 hybrid. In F1 hybrid, female will be wild type, male will be mutant type, and they have produced possible four types of gametes due to the gamete diffusion. These are the possible progenies developed from F2 generation. Out of 8 progeny, 4 will be male, 4 will be female, and 50% will be recombinant type, 50% will be parental type. These are all parental type progeny. Wild type, yellow and white, wild type, yellow and white, these are exactly resemble to their parents. These four are the recombinant type. That means these are produced through crossing over. Out of 4 chromatin, 2 will be crossing over. This crossing over chromatin fusion to form a recombinant type. Overall, F2 generation progeny developed. But out of these F2 generation progeny, parental type will be 98.7%. Almost 98.7% progeny, they are exactly similar to the parents. But only 1.3% they have shows recombinantal type. Recombinantal type only 1.3%. Because the reason is the two genes, selected two genes, color and eye genes, they have present very close to each other. They have more linked genes, hence they have shows parental type more. Recombinantal type will be very less. because the parent daughter will be 98%, recombinant type will be 1.3%. The cross 1. Next, he conducted cross 2. In the cross also selected two genes. One is Y type, another one is mediator wing. I character and wing characters he selected for second cross. Female have conceived white eye and miniature wing, male have conceived red eyes and full wings. And male is the wild type, female is the mutant, recessive type. Look at the genes and chromosome. White eye present in this region, mediature wing. They have shown some distance and far away from the between these two genes. Hence, the two genes are less linked because the distance will be more compared to first one. Okay, and how the progeny will develop? In your fourth generation, these are the gametes. Male have produced two types of gametes, female have produced only one type of gametes because they have the two X chromosomes. Next, in your fourth progeny, two X chromosomes are fused to form a Y type female, X and Y chromosome fused to form a recessive male, white and miniature wing of male. These are the F1 progeny. Then in F2 generation, the cross between the F1 progenies, F2 generation, these are the possible progenies will develop. These are all parental type, these are all recombinant type. But in the cross, parental type will be 62.8%. 62.8% and recombinant type will be 37.2%. Means in the cross the recombinant type will be increases. In first cross it will be only 1.3%. In cross 2, 37.2%. What is the reason? The reason is the distance between the two genes. When the genes are loosely arranged or loosely linked, recombinant type will be more. Okay, this is the Mendelian Morgan experiment. Compare the two crosses. One means the first cross have shown 98.7% parental and recombinant 1.3%. Cross B have shown 62.8% and recombinant 37.2%. Recombinant type will increase in cross B because the genes are loosely linked. First cross genes are tightly linked. It is the main reason for production of recombinant type. It is a complete Morgan experiment. Finally, Morgan have concluded their experiment. The conclusion is very, very important. Okay? What is the conclusion of Morgan linkage experiment? He says that when the two genes are tightly linked or tightly arranged on the same chromosome, tightly arranged on the same chromosome, it means They have shown more parental type and less recombinant type. For example, in cross A, they have shown 98.7% parental type, 1.3% will be recombinant type. And when the two genes are loosely linked, they have shown high recombination. The distance between white eye and mediator wing, the distance is more as they have shown 37.2% recombination. It is a complete concept of linkage and crossing over. It is one of the very, very important and interesting topic for your CET and NEET. Okay? Finally, when the two genes are very close to each other, they do not show independent assignment as they have produced parental similar progenies. When the two genes are less linked, they have shown more recombinant type. It is the complete conclusion of linkage. Okay? Thank you so much.